Hello?
Right now.
What? You're kidding, right now?
No, the deal was when I call you start. St. Patty's Day, baby, I want to get lucky.
Yeah, that's all well and good, Ashley, but there's people all around me.
I know, I'm sitting in front of them. And if you remember, the deal at the therapist was when I call, you start, so start.
Well, can I at least go somewhere else?
I don't care, just go.
Where should I go?
Which one? I don't care, just start.
Ashley, this is a lot of pressure.
I don't care, you promised.
Okay, just give me a minute to think. I'm feeling really alone right now.
Oh, really? Because that's exactly how I feel when you come home from work every night and lock yourself in the office and ignore me. I want romance again. I want us again.
I know, so do I, but I don't know why we gotta do this stupid phone call stuff. There's gotta be another way.
Look, do you want to stay together or don't you? Because if you don't give me this, I'm out.
Look, I know what I agreed to, and I do want to stay together. I definitely, definitely do.
Good. Then start.
What are you wearing?
That is so lame. You can see what I'm wearing.
Oh, come on. Jesus, help me out here. Come on, just throw me a bone or something.
Oh, you want a bone, baby? Okay. Here's a bone for you. My undies are see-through, and I bought them just for you. Does that help?
Wow. Yes. Definitely. Okay. What I really wanted to say was,
Oh my God! Spit it out, Tim! Come on!
I am trying to, but it is really difficult with all these people watching me. Why can't I just couch what I want to say so it doesn't really like sound, you know, so sexual?
If it doesn't sound sexual, how's it gonna be phone sex?
Well, why can't I say it when it makes it seem like I'm saying something else, you know, like innocuous?
I have no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
Follow my lead. Right now, I am thinking of your lovely pot of gold.
What?
Well, you know, your pot of gold. and I have a tam o'shanter that is getting quite frisky.
You have a hat that's getting excited. What are you, a cartoon?
Listen, I am trying my best here, and if you keep making fun of me, I'm not going to be able to get through.
I'm sorry. Go ahead, Lucky Charms.
I would really, really, really like to put my glock in your mora.
My mora? That's just pathetic.
I'm sorry, but I am really uncomfortable
here.
You're
not even trying. You're supposed to be turning me on. Instead, you're doing Brigadoon.
Well, this is really tough for me.
So what, that's it?
No, that's not it. I just don't want to do this whole phone sex thing, like right here.
I specifically chose right here because I wanted you to prove to me that you were willing to fight for me. I'll tell you. Our sex life and, our relationship in general, it's just not working for me anymore.
I'm sorry you feel that way. But I've told you a million times, I'm focusing on my career right now. It has to come first.
I understand that, I really do. But I feel like you're going to have to make the decision whether your career is more important or I am.
You are.
Well, that's not what your actions are saying. Your actions are saying you're not interested in me.
No, I am. I swear I am. I'm the sexiest woman I know, and the smartest.
You prove it to me. Turn me on.
Actually, these phone sex calls are not going to solve our problems. You know that, right?
And what is?
I don't know. I just know that I need to focus on my career, and I'm telling you, you need to understand I'm doing it for us.
I don't believe you.
It's true, I swear.
Okay, so what happens then when you hit it big and next thing you know, oh, I have to be on set 3 hours before my call time, and oh, I stay 2 hours after we wrap, and every time you come home, I'm already asleep. How's it going to be any different then?
Essie, I'm an actor. I can't control my schedule.
Exactly. So what you're saying is ignoring me isn't going to change, so I really don't know what to do anymore. I really don't.
I want to be here, Amy, and I'm here. I mean, what do you want me to do?
I want you to fight for me. I want you to step out of your comfort zone and turn me on. Make me feel that I matter.
Do I have to die?
How else are you going to call me?
Well, I mean, I'm sitting right here. I mean, do I really have to dial? Can I, like, pretend not?
You can pretend
that.
That's fine.
Ringing.
Oh. Hello.
I really love you. More for me tonight.
Ooh, thank you for noticing.
You look really hot.
Even in my itchy underwear.
Take them off?
Yes.
Me too. Well, I mean mine. I mean, I want to take mine off. Not that they're itchy or anything, but it's just funny. I'm thinking, oh, what I really wanted to say was, you are the sexiest woman I've ever met.
Really?
Yeah.
I like that.
That's not all.
Excellent. Tell me more.
Any man would be honored to have you as his partner. And not only sexual, I mean all of you. I mean, you're warm, you're funny, you're exciting.
Ooh, and you're way turning me on now.
Good. Because what I really want to say to you is, I love you. Even through all this phone sex calls and... God, you have amazing eyes, by the way.
You've been so good to me in a really long time.
Sorry. I didn't mean to take you for granted.
Why am I being called?
Maybe I was using up all my fake cell phone minutes or something like that.
Oh, this is fake
to
you now?
No, the actual call was fake. The conversation wasn't fake.
Oh, okay. Then no, you are not using too many fake cell phone minutes. You have the unlimited fake life.
Good. Because what I really wanted to say to you was that I want to be present for you. I mean it. I adore you. And you were right. I've been spending way too much time on work, but I promise you, swear to God, that I'm doing it for us.
You're turning me off again.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's right. The main thing is you.
Better. And are your actions going to reflect that from now on?
Yes, they are.
See some of those actions here, Miss Sexy Man?
Sure.
Where?
In the bedroom.
Boring.
On this table, maybe?
Interesting.
You think it's big enough?
I don't know. What do you have in mind?
Ashley, you know we're still in front of a room of people, right?
Just stare at the camera. Come on, tell me what kind of you
want to
have.
Okay, but I'm going to tell you my way.
Oh, God. All right. God.
You see, I have this lucky shamrock. I'm dying to show it to you.
Oh, my lucky stars. And when I see this lucky shamrock, is it going to give me the urge to play a tune on your big Celtic pipe?
Aye, lassie, me big strapping Celtic pipes.
And then is it going to make me crave a big side of warm corned beef?
It is. And I'm going to thrust that right into your bed with cabbage.
Ow!
Oh, I should have gone with the shillelagh.
Oh, yes. I love my big walking.
you know, maybe we should move this conversation to somewhere a little more private. You know, without our cell phones and audiences.
No, this seems a little boring. I mean, you're gonna have to entice me. What can I get there that I can't get here?
All my attention, my unbanished love, and my promise that I will never, ever undervalue again. And there's this leprechaun there, who just goes crazy with the itchy see-through underwear.
Well, top of the morning to you. Let's go.
Hey, before we do go back there and meet this little leprechaun, and it's going to get a tad bit nasty. I just want you to know that I love you.
Baby. You're going to get so lucky tonight.